Good evening, everyone. From the Bog Ice Arena in Kingston, Massachusetts, is a presentation of MyHockeyLive.com. I'm Jake Levin, flying solo on tonight's broadcast for the Sacred Heart Saints and the Tri-County Votech Cougars. Sacred Heart coming in winners of their last game out against the Southeastern West Bridgewater Hawks. Tri-County coming in. They are 6-1 in the Mayflower Conference, 10-1 overall. Sacred Heart 7-5-2 overall, but 5-1-2 in the Mayflower. Play is underway, and it's a Sacred Heart start. John Quinn up the middle, front line center, backhand bid from his right wing. That was Josh McCafferty pounding it. Went wide to the far side. Puck immediately cleared down the length of the ice back to the defenseman. Steve Firm plays the puck. Quinn, McCafferty, Kazmuski, your front line tonight for Sacred Heart. Steve Firm, Ryan Leonard, your top defensive pair. And this Firm lays the body. Big hit on Connor Harrington, top line left wing for the Cougars. Behind the net, that's Leonard. Jams on the brakes, goes back in the other direction. Knocked away temporarily. Coming out with the puck is Firm. That's Firm with the puck from behind his own goal. Tries to clear. Intercepted at the point by the Hawks. That is Flanagan. Cougars, my apologies. Hawks still on the mind. In net tonight for the Cougars is Chris Mooney. Number one, he is a sophomore. Ian Fillion getting the start tonight for Sacred Heart. He is a junior. Alternate captain from Halifax, Massachusetts. Both these schools have players from other towns in which they are located. Tri-County, of course, being a vocational school. Sacred Heart, a private Catholic institution. No shots on goal yet for Tri-County. Sacred Heart has the one, and it was wide. So neither goalie really yet been tested in the inaugural minute 30 of this contest. Teams feeling each other out through the neutral zone. Here's C.J. Roy trying to send the puck into his attacking end. He does so, but it's intercepted immediately by the Saints. Dan Lincoln up the other way. Dan Lincoln drops it off for Leonard. Leonard tucks it, and it goes wide just to the near side of the goal. One off the apron there. 13-12 to go, first period, still a scoreless game. Through the neutral zone. That's Liam Walsh turning around with a puck, and Dan Lincoln's going to give chase up the right wing. Dan Lincoln pinches into the circle, fires, and he misplayed the puck. Cougars are able to come up with it. Goss up the other way for Tri-County. Clears all the way, and it slows down a little bit, slows down in the slot. Able to come up with the puck are the Saints. That's Matt Finn. He's a sophomore from Kingston, playing for his hometown team. Along the end boards. Moving off. Top of the slot. Fired shot. Score. Connor Harrington finds the back of the net from top of the slot. Excellent feed from behind the net from Chris Boyd. It's 1-0 Tri-County. 2 minutes, 28 seconds into this game. Sacred Heart not used to trailing, especially at home. See how that affects them playing from behind. Tri-County's look like the sharper team here in the early going. So Harrington, the captain, gets the scoring started. 1-0 Tri-County. Back out for the draw. One again by Jake Ducharme, top line center for the Cougars. Goes back into the Sacred Heart defensive end. They'll try to clear. Back through the neutral zone now is Harrington. Sends it off the sidewall. Behind the net it winds up. Filling out to plays it. Leaves it for Leonard, who sends down a defender in his way. That was Ducharme. McCafferty with puck goes cross ice and up towards Quinn. Quinn's your leading goal scorer. Jack of all trades for Sacred Heart. He fires and it's deflected by C.J. Roy wide to the near side. Coming up with puck is Kazmuski on the far side right wing on the half wall. Fired it. It was blocked in front. Harrington plays the puck in the neutral zone. Bit too aggressively, comes back to Leonard. Right out towards the red line, knocked down by Flanagan. Flanagan gains entry to the zone, knocked away by Leonard. It is Kazmuski, has the puck redirected, winds right back up for Quinn, and Quinn backhands it into the neutral zone. Good play by him, gets it up to Dan Lincoln. That would have been an odd man rush for the Cougars. Lincoln moving into the left corner, gets poke checked off the play by Roy. Moving off the half wall and playing the puck with his hand. A little illegal carry of sorts there. I believe that was Walsh. So we're going to get a draw in the neutral zone. 11:19 to go in the first period. Tri-County with a 1-0 lead. Connor Harrington's goal. Second line out there now for Sacred Heart. Draws one by Colin Gillis. He's a junior captain from Halifax. Shoots it up the ice. Liam Walsh gains it up the left wing, trying to send it in towards the center, towards Gillis. Shot. Saved by Mooney. Goes into the right corner. Far side of the ice. Pinching him at the point is Firm. Trying to poke it down for Lincoln in the corner. Also down there was Gillis. Tri-County able to clear the zone. It is going to go wide, but it slows down a little bit, so Fillion comes out to play it. Negating and icing. Gets it out to Cormac Perry. Cormac Perry redirects it for Firm. Firm jams on the brakes and carries the puck out of his defensive end through the neutral zone. No look pass up for Dan Lincoln. Gains the line. Lincoln puts a move on one defender. Lincoln shot. Got deflected. Rebound. Shot. Score. Steve Firm crashing the net down from the point, and he has tied the game at one apiece. Goal comes at 4:29 of the first period. It's now 1-1. That was the question, how Sacred Heart would play from behind. They're not used to trailing, particularly at home. They have tied the game. Only took about 2 minutes, 20 or so seconds. So Steve Firm, that is his fourth goal of the season. Sophomore from Kingston. Cougars again win the draw. They've had more luck tonight in the early going in the faceoff circle, but it's intercepted in the defensive end. Kick save Mooney. Ducharme is also there to deflect it a bit. Behind the net, Liam Flynn from Hingham, Massachusetts. Flynn towards Dara Perry. Dara Perry looking towards the slot. It's Leonard. Leonard's going to fire. Pad save Mooney with his right leg. Goes out to Harrington. Harrington diagonal pass knocked off by Dara Perry in the neutral zone. Gets right back into the attacking end. Gains the line. Perry with some stick handling, leaving it for Flynn. Flynn into the slot. Backhand, and it's another save by Mooney. Rebound comes loose. Another save Mooney. That was off Dara Perry's shot. Dara Perry with the puck. He gets taken down behind the net. Looks like McLaughlin may have tripped him up. No call. Still alive in the attacking end for Sacred Heart. Leonard redirection into the corner. Flynn still down there to play it. Make that Dara Perry. Puck goes into a bit of no man's land, and the Cougars take advantage. A 3-on-2 rush if they hustle. They're going to change the players, however. Skating is Boyd. Boyd shot, saved by Fillion. Rebound comes directly to Flynn. That's going to be nice. 9:17 to go in the first period. 1-1 game. Connor Harrington, the goal for Tri-County. Steve Firm, the goal for Sacred Heart. Justin Most to take the draw against Captain John Coyne here. Draw coming far side of the ice. Won by Most, intercepted immediately by the Saints. Getting it right back is Connor Flanagan. Flanagan sends it behind the net towards Most. Most knocked off the play by Flynn. Trying to go back up ice, it's Gillis. Taken down into the neutral zone. I believe that was Ducharme that got in the way. Here comes McCaffrey. McCaffrey pinching and shot, score! McCaffrey from an impossible angle. Sends it through the five hole of Chris Mooney. He wants that one back. And at 8:50 to go in the first period, Sacred Heart has taken the lead for the first time tonight. It's 2-1. Joshua McCaffrey, freshman from Weymouth, Mass. 5'5", 175 pounds. That is his fourth goal of the season. 21st point. Gets a lot of assists playing on that top line with John Quinn. So it's now 1-1. We're not even 2-1, I'm sorry. We're not even halfway through the first period. Leonard with the puck. Cross point for Firm. Firm and the Saints looking to go back up ice. They want more. They have two goals in the span of about 2 minutes. McCaffrey's seen eye goal. Beat Chris Mooney five hole at 6:10 of the first period. Tri-County trying to set up shop in their attacking end. It's Chris Boyd knocked off the play. Out through the neutral zone. Quinn couldn't get the redirect. Tri-County rolling really only three lines here. They're rolling four defensive pairings. Lack of depth, few injuries clearly hurt them. Stoppage in play, 8:04 to go in the first. one of three games on the MyHockeyLive family of networks tonight. Earlier, you may have heard Boston College High School taking on Malden Catholic. Lack of suspense, the Lancers clinched the Catholic Conference. They're looking for their fifth consecutive Super 8 title. Saints win the draw out to the point. It's Quinn. Quinn's going to fire that. They're on the power play, by the way. Neglected to mention that. Quinn for Firm. Firm's pass was almost intercepted. Most redirects it towards the corner. Quinn keeping it alive at the point. Dan Lincoln on the half wall. Pinches off back over to Quinn at the far point. Quinn skates into the right side circle into the slot. Poke checked away by Flanagan. Firm assumes control of the puck at the near point. Firm redirects behind towards Kazmuski. Looking for Lincoln. It goes all the way past Firm, back down to Philly, and still have 53 seconds to go on the man advantage for Sacred Heart. Over halfway to go in the first. And Firm leaves the puck at the far half wall. Flanagan was almost able to pick it off and move in. He was thwarted by the Sacred Heart defense. Power play right now for Sacred Heart. They're on the wrong end of the ice for that. Firm up ice, can't connect with Walsh, and it is going to fall in for an ice. Still 29 seconds to go. No shots on goal yet on the man advantage for the Saints. Looks like the second power play unit has come on now for the most part for Sacred Heart. Draw is won by Derek Perry. Went right back towards Fillion. Almost had to make a save on that. Cleared out of the zone. But the Cougars send it back where they want it. Sacred Heart defensive end. Ryan Leonard, the eighth grader, with a puck. Looking for an outlet pass. Finds one with Joshua McCafferty up the left side. Gains the line, leaves it for Dara Perry. Dara Perry backhands it from the circle, chipping it towards the slot. And Tri-County County is able to ice the puck, or clear the puck out of the zone anyways, killing the penalty. Good job by them. Sacred Heart did not have a single shot on goal. Leonard goes down behind the net, picked up by Ducharme. Ducharme out to the circle. Shot fired, and it went wide over the shoulder of Fillion. That was Ducharme at the point. Send it out to Bazigian, I should say. Bazigian. Swallowed up in the corner. Staying with it is Harrington, and Harrington just goes offside with 6:03 to go in the first period. Bazigian is the name I was having trouble pronouncing. My apologies there. Kyle Bazigian wears number 4. He is a junior. Gillis stick the draw against Connor McCaffrey. Quinn Gillis, rather, won the draw. Far corner, it's Firm. Cluster around the puck in the far corner boards. Firm gets stapled off the play from behind by McCaffrey. Out at the far point, Burdette plays the puck. Burdette top of the slot towards D'Souza, and the Saints defense is able to sweep him away. Back up ice they come. Gillis, long pass up for Flynn. Flynn, backhand shot saved by Mooney. And the Cougars going back the other way now. And looks like I am solo no longer.
Heck of a time getting here, but we're finally here.
Hey, you know, traffic's tough out there, especially with all the snow.
You got that right.
I'm Jake Levin. I am joined, of course, by
Andrew Greenberg.
Andrew, pleasure as always. 5:02 to go in the first period. Sacred Heart with a 2-1 lead. There's Ryan Leonard with some moves. Top of slot, backhands it towards the corner boards. Down towards Kazmuski. Kazmuski on the wraparound bid, can't get it to fall. From the point, Cormac Perry with a blast, and it goes off the legs of Bazigian. Out into the neutral zone, hops up over the stick of Leonard. Leonard defensively. Able to get it up towards Kazmuski. Kazmuski up the left wing. Sends it into the zone, and giving chase now is Quinn. Quinn moving into the near corner boards. Centering pass towards the slot. Couldn't connect that one with McCafferty. 4:19 to go, first period. Sacred Heart still on top, 1-0. 2-1. One goal lead, I should say. Pinching in from the point. That's Matt Finn, sophomore. moves into the half wall, sends it down towards Kazmuski behind the net. Kazmuski stays with the puck in the slot, backhand bid for Quinn. Knocked off, he was strong-armed by Nick Young, still at the point. Batted in and cleared out finally. That was a nice shot by Matt Finn. That was blocked. Andrew, takeaways from since you got here.
Well, that last shift there, like many of Sacred Heart's opponents, they're having a lot of difficulty dealing with John Quinn's size in deep there. He is a big boy, 6'3", well over 200 pounds, willing to play physical, willing to use his body to shield the puck, get position. He's very, very tough to deal with.
33 points on the season. He has not yet factored into the scoring at all tonight, but plenty of time left. Sure, that has plenty of chance to change. 3:45 to go, first period. Tri-County with a rush. That was Harrington. He's the goal scorer tonight for the Cougars. Thwarted there by Firm and Perry. We get a stoppage. I think this is going to be a cross-check called against the Saints.
Looks like that's going to be number three, Liam Flynn, going to the box.
Liam Flynn, the Hingham native, 6 feet, 175 pounds. One goal, two assists on the season for Flynn. So the Saints will be shorthanded for the first time tonight.
And we're going to get our first shot to look at the Tri-County power play, see what they can come up with.
Sacred Heart power play is 0 for 1. They do not have a single shot on goal. See if Tri-County can fare any better. Firm out there trying to kill the penalty. Clears it out. McLaughlin couldn't get his stick down at the far point. Trickles all the way down to Mooney. He took his time getting to the puck. If Sacred Heart had wanted a forecheck there, a little gamble, would have been a good opportunity, Andrew.
Yeah, it could have been.
Batted in the neutral zone by Ducharme behind the net. Firm is the first one there. Stapled up on the end boards by Harrington. Harrington still battling against Firm, who worked it over towards Leonard. Picked off by Boyd. Moves out to the point. One-timer, and it is wide to the near side from McLaughlin. Still down in the Tri-County attacking zone. 49 seconds to go. This power play is not yet halfway over. Went off the body of Quinn, off the end boards, and Leonard tees up, gives it everything he has, and clears it out of the zone beyond Mike Goss, a co-captain for Tri-County. Mooney out of his net to play it, leaving it for Goss. Bit of confusion there. Simply comes to McMillan. McMillan sends it the length of the ice and a save by Mooney. Dan Lincoln getting aggressive on the forecheck. 20 seconds to go. Sacred Heart looking like a dominant penalty-killing team. Is pinching in from the point is Walsh. Walsh looking for Lincoln in the slot. Gets taken off the play on the end boards by McLaughlin. No shots on goal yet for Tri-County on this man advantage. They still have 3 seconds to go. That puck is behind Harrington. That enables, Firm to get there in time. This is going to go for an ice, 1:58 to go. Takeaway on that Tri-County power play.
Well, I'd have to say that the Sacred Heart coaching staff would have to be more than pleased with the job their team did killing off that penalty. With the pressure they had in the offensive zone at the end, you had to wonder which team was on the power play and which team was killing a penalty.
Yeah, absolutely, particularly the second half of that power play. Sacred Heart took control and had some chances. Extend their lead to 2. Minute 57 to go. Draw one by the Cougars at the point. Batted in by Roy. Intercepted by Gillis. At the near point. Pinching down further to play is Flanagan. Flanagan towards the slot. Backhand bid. Saved by Fillion. Good bid there by Bazgian. Attempting to clear and succeeding is Kazmuski. Gets it up to Quinn. John Quinn goes between the legs of one defender. Picks the near side of the post and goes a bit too wide. Minute 27 to go. Sacred Heart setting up shop in the attacking zone. It's Kazmuski in the slot towards Quinn. Quinn tried to go to the backhand between two defenders. Bit too slow, and it cleared all the way back into the Sacred Heart defensive end.
Well, Quinn certainly is impressive, and he's got the numbers to prove it.
The leading scorer on this team for a reason. The team's got a game plan him on a nightly basis. Just over a minute to go in the first. Sacred Heart with a 2-1 lead. A game they trailed 1-0 initially. Connor Harrington's goal. And there's almost a costly turnover. A steal in the attacking end by Tyler Kane. Can't make anything happen. Fillion holding the post and it deflects up right around the crossbar. A glove knocked the puck away. I believe that was Steve Firm's hand. And now skating towards the puck is Liam Flynn up the far side right. Flynn goes along the end boards, and he takes down C.J. Roy, but lost the puck in the process. 34 seconds to go. Tied up in the corner boards is Dara Perry. Skating over to help Miss Flynn. Tri-County trying to get the clear. kept alive, at least for the time being, by Firm there at the half wall on the near side of the ice. 22 seconds to go in the first period. Sacred Heart has certainly controlled the pace of play, but they only lead by one. It's a 2-1 game. 14 seconds to go. Puck moves to the other side of the sheet. Matt Foley clears it out at the neutral zone at the red line right in front of the scorer's bench. Knocking at the puck was McMillan. Behind the net, 3 seconds to go, and Firm is very contentious. Skating off this period, pinching the puck up against the boards. And that will do it for the first period here at the Bog. 2-1 is your Sacred Heart lead.
Well, Sacred Heart's got to be happy with that period. Got the one goal lead at the end. Very important league game here. Tri-County 6-1 in the league. Sacred Heart with a 5-1-2 record in the league. Sacred Heart win here could, you know, really put them in a position, you know, to kind of put a hammerlock on the league standings going down the stretch here at the end.
Absolutely. Sacred Heart playing their best hockey as the season winds down. So we're going to take a break, kick it back to Art, manning the camera. Keep it locked to MyHockeyLive.com. We'll be back for some second period action in about 10 minutes.
I wanted the snack bar to be open, it was tonight, so of course it's not.
Where would you have to drive from?
Newton, to my offices. And my late afternoon appointment showed up late. And I couldn't get him out of the mail.
We are back. Second period action here at My Hockey Live. Jake Levin alongside Andrew Greenberg. Andrew, Sacred Heart with a 2-1 lead after trailing 1-0 in the early stages. And here we go, Connor Harrington on the backhand, shorthand, he scores! Connor Harrington's second goal of the night. I couldn't even get finished. What I was going to say is that Harrington gave Tri-County, rather, the early 1-0 lead. 12 seconds into the second period, he ties it up at 2.
Well, I guess that would truly be a case of deja vu. That would also truly not be the start that Coach McDonald was hoping his team would get off to.
No, absolutely not. He was in good spirits intermission, and I talked to him. Pumped up about the lead. Was hoping they could have scored a few more. Yeah, definitely a momentum killer there if you're Sacred Heart, but they've responded once. Can they do it again? There's John Quinn. Quinn in, fires it off the end glass. Gets past Leonard on the near point. That was unbelievably played by Connor Harrington, just taking it by himself on the... Not shorthanded, but, you know, no men to beat. Unbelievable play.
No, it was a heck of an individual effort. There's no doubt about that.
2-2 is now our score. It's a brand-new hockey game. Puck in the neutral zone. There's Harrington. Pass intended for McLaughlin. Goes back into his defensive end. Quinn giving chase. Moving over to the far side half wall. Harrington tangled up momentarily with Kazmuski. Mooney still in net for the Cougars. Fillion, of course, still in net for the Saints. Back and playing is Leonard. Trying to connect with him, Cafferty, able to get it up to Gillis. And here come the Cougars, 3-on-2. It's Boyd up the left wing, pinching in and playing that one well was Perry, and having to react at the last second to making a save was Fillion.
Yeah, Fillion really has had one heck of a season up to this point with a mouth-watering 1.97 goals against average and a save percentage well over 930.
Not too shabby. Remember, he's a junior. He'll be back to do it again next year. Yeah, that puck, I'm not sure it was so much a shot from Boyd. It just kept trickling and trickling in, and Fillion had to extend his near leg to hold that post. Fillion loses his stick. I think he wants a penalty call.
Yeah, he didn't seem too pleased there.
It seems Bezgian may have kicked it. And sure enough, Bezgian is going to go, I believe. No, it's just going to be a draw out of the zone.
Net was dislodged.
Okay. Bezgian, he was skating towards the penalty box. The official pointed towards it. Tried to put two and two together, I guess. Not the case. So play resumes 5-on-5. Cormac Perry up for Dan Lincoln. Redirected by C.J. Roy in the neutral zone. Moving down is Connor Flanagan. Tangled up with Cormac Perry on the corner boards. Flanagan trying to get beyond Perry. Also down there is Walsh for the Saints. Wraparound bid by Flanagan. Didn't even get the shot off. Shot taken by Boyd, and here comes a 2-on-2 rush for the Saints. Trying to split through the defense was Gillis. He got tripped up. No call. It was inadvertent. Now here comes Flanagan. Centering pass. He couldn't connect with Bezgian. Would have been a very dangerous 2-on-1 against Sacred Heart. Tri-County's been the better team this period, Andrew.
Yeah, they've gotten off to a hot start here. A lot of pep in their step.
Very physical as well. Sacred Heart trying to get it out of their defensive end. Tangled up just outside the right of the blue line. They're going to try to regroup. Quinn with puck. Sends it up. Couldn't connect with Walsh. Sacred Heart going to take a much-needed line change. Taking a tour of his defensive end now is Burdett. Burdett, long diagonal. Connects with Boyd. Boyd goes backwards. Try to work it up for Harrington. And why not? He's got two so far tonight. Unable to force that puck in there. Harrington pinches into the far side half wall up the left wing. Defensive end. Tri-County trying to break out now, and they have numbers. 2-on-1. It's Flanagan. Flanagan centering pass knocked away by Firm.
Yeah, he was looking for Harrington steaming down the slot there for a chance of the hat trick.
Got to keep an eye on him. Here comes Flynn. Was not the first man to the ice. The puck, I should say, knocked away by Capobianco. And the neutral zone goes off of Boyd, redirects behind the net of Fillion, going to get tangled up in the corner. He anticipated it, able to knock it loose for Ducharme. Out to the point, Capobianco tees it up and is blocked off the stick of Firm. He clears it the length of the ice. This is going to be an icing back in the Sacred Heart defensive end. 11:09 to go.
Well, once again, Tri-County's definitely very much carrying the play territorially so far in this period. We're still only about 4 minutes in here. There's plenty of time for Sacred Heart to turn this around, but Tri-County's definitely got momentum built up at the moment.
Quinn wins the draw for the Saints. Can't get out of the zone, however, and in front of the net, backhand save made by Fillion. Backhanded bid on the short side by Justin Most. That was a good opportunity to give Tri-County the lead back with an even 4 minutes into the second period.
Always difficult to stop those backhand shots. It's so hard for the goalie to accurately follow the puck off the stick.
Almost acts like a changeup in baseball sometimes. You know, it's slower, obviously, than the forehand, but that's what makes it difficult to react to.
Yeah, very hard to read.
Quinn gains the line through the middle. Has puck knocked away. Backhand it carried forward. Kazmuski knocked it wide to the far side. Quinn jockeying for position in front. The wraparound bid, and he is stoned on the near post by Mooney. His tempers flare a little bit.
Yeah, you always got to be careful of Quinn coming behind the net like that with that reach on the wraparound. He scored a goal on a wraparound like that against Dennis Yarmouth last week here.
Looks like we're going to get a line change for Sacred Heart. They send off just about everybody.
Really
Matt
must,
Finn stays on.
Really must be nice being 6'5" like that.
Have your room to roam, no question.
Yeah,
definitely creates options.
Walsh behind the net towards Perry. Make that Lincoln. Lincoln skating around the attacking zone. Jams on the bricks in the corner. Sent the puck to Flynn and got it right back. Misfired. Here comes Tri-County up the other way. Matt Foley gains the line, dumps it in. Cormac Perry going to be the first man of the puck for Sacred Heart. 10:04 to go, second period, and a tied hockey game at the Bog. Wednesday night hockey here on My Hockey Live. Losing a stick, the Sacred Heart player, that was Goss, making that Tri-County player. And Harrington gains the line by himself, moves into the right circle, tried to put a move on Cormac Perry, lost the puck in the process. That is Finn picking up the loose puck in his defensive end, works it up for Gillis, intercepted by Harrington. Harrington goes between the legs of Gillis, centering pass, and a save by Fillion, rebound. He extends with a pat. I'm not sure that was even a shot. Wound up hitting off the end boards. Coming out with the puck, Cormac Perry. Cormac Perry goes backwards in order to get the puck over to Matt Finn. Finn will try to clear. He gets knocked off the play by Harrington. Sagard having all kinds of trouble here. Finally able to clear it out. Dan Lincoln. But right back comes Daniel McLaughlin. Tri-County clearly in control of this hockey game in the second period. Harrington set the tone 12 seconds in. There's a costly turnover. Foley had it atop the slot. Able to get his stick in the way at the last second was Bassey McMillan. Still in the neutral zone.
Yeah, Sacred Heart being uncharacteristically careless with the puck on a couple of occasions here. But I'll tell you, you really got to be impressed with Connor Harrington. You know, another what's called great play, stick handling the puck into the zone there. Another big scoring opportunity. Phil, you with the save this time. Two goals already, clearly looking for more.
He's been a one-man wrecking crew for the Cougars. Cougars win the draw, poked free in the neutral zone. A two-on-one developing. It's going to be Foley up the left wing. He gets there just as it was about to cross the end line. Couldn't get a clean centering pass. Dara Perry there with a backhand. Fanning at the pass was Roy. And now here come the Saints up the other way. That was Flynn pinching in from the left. And that gets redirected into the corner boards. Dara Perry had the puck in front of him. Wasn't aware of it. C.J. Roy tries to clear the zone and does so. Back into the neutral zone. And the defensive end now for Ryan Leonard. Leonard skips the puck over a few people, back into the Sacred Heart. Tri-County make that defensive end. Dara Perry for John Quinn. Quinn's been quiet tonight. Sacred Heart's going to take control of this game. It's going to have to start with him. Quinn skating around the neutral zone. Leonard winds up with the puck. Ryan Leonard goes to the backward direction, works the puck up for Flynn. Flynn had the line gain, trying to knock it down top the zone. Was D'Amelio unable to do so. Back the other way they come. It's Ryan Leonard, first man of the puck for Sacred Heart. Trying to battle it out with Connor Flanagan. 7:30 to go. We're halfway through this period, halfway through this hockey game. Redirecting the puck in front was Most. Couldn't connect with Flanagan. Bazgian thought about playing it at the point. Didn't want to reach out. Got to Nick Young. Near point now. This has the look of a power play for Tri-County. It is not the case. 7:11 to go in the period. Here come the Saints. 3-on-2, they're going to drop a man for a line change, and Quinn gets taken down. That is about as blatant a trip from behind as you're going to see. Guilty party, Nick Young, since going the power play.
Yep, you know, Quinn jumped forward there, was coming into the zone with momentum, and really left him no choice but to take him down there. Draws the penalty, puts his team on the power play. You know, as you said, despite the 20 goals, you know, he hasn't been in the score sheet yet this game, but there's only so long he can hold down the mighty Quinn.
He's going to be out there running the point on the power play with Steve Firm opposite him. Gillis, Lincoln, and Walsh also up front for the Saints. Behind the net, it's Lincoln. Cycles out to the left, leaving it for Flynn. Flynn had the puck knocked away from him by Goss, and they are able to clear the zone. Fillion comes out of his net. He's going to send it over to Firm. Had to put a move on there to avoid a charging Dake Ducharme. Firm with the puck. Minute 03 to go on the man advantage. Gaining the line was Flynn. Send it out of the zone. Tri-County goes all the way back to Fillion. Gillis, pivot man on the power play. Shooting up the center of the ice, pinches over to the right, now moves into the right side circle as he gains the line. Centering pass, couldn't connect with either Lincoln or Walsh. Walsh at the far side, half wall for firm at the point. Tees it up, and it lands just off the top of the board. Takes a Sacred Heart bounce, stays down there with Quinn. He gets tangled up, and I think we're going to have another penalty against Tri-County.
Yeah, as I've said before, you know, with that great size that he has, you know, when he drives the net hard like that, to try to take on a guy 6'5" and, you know, well over 200 pounds one-on-one like that, it's just you're asking a heck of a lot out of any defenseman to try to handle that in a one-on-one matchup.
Dan McLaughlin, the guilty party. So it's going to be 5-on-3 for 26 seconds. And then after that, an abbreviated minute, four-second power play for Sacred Heart.
Of course, the unfortunate thing for Sacred Heart being that Quinn was out there for so long that they've had to take him off the ice during this 5-on-3.
Ryan Leonard tees it up and scores. Ryan Leonard at the near point. Mooney didn't have a chance at that. He went low to the glove side and beat the goalie for the 5-on-3 goal, and the Saints retake the lead 3-2 with 5:50 to go in the second period.
And that's Leonard's first goal of the year, and an extremely opportune time to come through with that. We've talked about how young the Sacred Heart team is. He's an eighth grader. Not a freshman, an eighth grader.
Wasn't even alive in the 1990s.
Leonard missing out.
Leonard rewarded with his first goal of the season. He's on the top defensive pair. He has been for the past few games. He gets rewarded with a 5-on-3 goal, a blast from the point. You could see it coming. As soon as they won the draw, Sacred Heart, he got the puck, and you knew he was shooting. They're still on the man advantage for a minute five now. Intercepted atop the zone as they try to clear by C.J. Roy. Goes back towards McCaffrey. McCaffrey taking his time up for Dara Perry. Almost intercepted by Flanagan. Winding up with the puck is McMillan. McMillan gained the line. Fire on net. Setting pass in the slot. Kazmuski tries to knock it home. And holding the post is Mooney for the save. Keep it a 3-2 hockey game.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Coach McDonald, it's really impressive the important ice time and positions, you know, that some really young guys in this team have been given. You know, you got Leonard, the eighth grader, on the first first defensive pairing. You got the two fabulous freshmen forward, Dan Lincoln and Liam Walsh, second liners, and up front in the power play. You would think that this team has a very strong future. I mean, there's almost no senior presence at all on this team.
Nope, you've got exactly two. One of them is Sam Chapman, backup goaltender. And you know, Andrew, I lied. It is only one senior. Thought Quinn was a senior for a second. My mistake. He's only a junior, hard as that is to believe.
Yep, no, he's got another year left of terrorizing opposition.
In the defensive end, a power play goes out with a whimper for Sacred Heart. Still 2 seconds to go and finally expires. Here comes Quinn shooting up the middle of the ice. Quinn to the backhand toe drag, trying to leave it for himself behind. Couldn't get there. Still alive at the near point. Batting at the puck was Gillis. From the corner, now behind the net, Dan Lincoln. Lincoln skates around the perimeter of the attacking end, leaving it for Gillis. And Tri-County's going to be able to clear out. And 1-on-0. Here comes Roy. Roy into the backhand. And this might be a penalty shot. We'll see.
I'm interested to see. And it is. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're about to witness one of the most exciting plays in sports, a penalty shot.
Ryan Leonard, the guilty party. That was actually Kyle Bazgian, not Roy. Apologies there. So Bazgian going to take the penalty shot for the Tri-County Cougars.
Well, I guess the eighth grader learned a bit of a lesson there on that play, kind of taken to school by Bazgian, who made a great move on him. Left Leonard no choice but to just get the stick on him and try to take him out of the play in any manner that he could. Consequences be darned.
You're going to give the penalty shot to Harrington here. I'm not sure if that's a rule. You're allowed to give it to whoever you want to.
I'm not sure, but this isn't the guy you want to be seeing if you're Sacred Heart.
Harrington takes the puck and starts slowly through the neutral zone, crosses the blue line, moves in through the slot, picks his spot and scores. Fillion didn't stand a chance. A simple, simplistic move there by Harrington. Picks a spot top shelf. That's the hat trick.
Throw the hats, ladies and gentlemen. That's three for Harrington as the Harrington reign of terror continues.
Penalty shot, goal ties the game at three.
And with 3:48 left in the second period, it's Sacred Heart 3, Connor Harrington 3.
Indeed. Draw is controlled, and here comes Harrington again, looking for his fourth. Harrington in, saved by Philly, and holds the post, rebound. Just goes wide to the near side of the post. Harrington almost had his fourth goal. Back the other way they come. It's Quinn darting up the right side of the ice. Quinn moves to the middle now. Quinn sprawled out in front, and that's going to be a goal? What happened there, Andrew?
Hard to tell from this angle. Very hard to tell from this angle.
It looked like Mooney was stretched out. And Mooney made the save.
And it looks like he did successfully make the save as they're setting up for a faceoff in the offensive zone. Quinn with a great attempt to come back with a big play of his own after Harrington capped off the hat trick before. Punch, counter punch.
Two great players duking it out. 3:24 to go, second period. It's a tied hockey game here at the Bog. Front of the Tri-County bench, we have a man down. Getting back up to his knees, it's Tyler Kane. Looks like he's okay, but this is going to be a penalty against Sacred Heart.
Tri-County to the power play with 3:13 left in the period. This is going to be their second opportunity of the game. Sacred Heart with a 5-on-3 power play goal this period. Let's see if Tri-County has an answer for them.
Special teams have been a factor tonight.
They usually are.
Gillis wins the draw for the Saints. Got it over towards Finn. Unable to clear. Here's Bayes-Jean. And it's cleared the length of the ice. Mooney out of his net to play it. Sends it up ice towards McLaughlin. McLaughlin almost lost the puck to Quinn. Not the person you want to turn the puck over to when you're on the man advantage. Intercepted atop the defensive end. That would have been Gillis shooting in with Quinn, the formidable duo, the two top line centers out there killing this penalty for Sacred Heart. And Firm sends it the other way. Tri-County having a hard time getting out of the neutral zone, let alone into the attacking zone. Here they go, though. It's Flanagan in through the left circle. Shot on Fillion and a goal. Fillion made the initial save, although not cleanly. It dropped between his legs and trickled in. Power play goal, and now Tri-County is back on top. It's 4-3.
Well, that's the first one I would venture to say that Fillion probably wishes that he had back. It wasn't from a terribly, tight an angle there. It looked like he was in good position, looked like he was square to the shooter, and, somehow it just drops between his legs and trickles through. And just like that, the Cougars are up a goal.
Just got finished saying how Sacred Heart was doing a phenomenal job killing the penalty. Spoke too soon. Here they come, they want more. It was Harrington darting in. Knocked off the play by Kazmuski. Gillis. Over towards Walsh. Still a loose puck in the neutral zone, trying to gain entry. That was Harrington, fired it on net. Fillion redirected it with a sick save towards the corner boards. We're inside 2 minutes to go in the second period. The complexion of this game has changed. Sacred Heart now trails 4-3. Second time tonight they've trailed. They trailed 1-0. And now 4-3 much later on in the contest. Gillis prying the puck free from the sidewall. Worked it, but Roy was able to redirect the puck. Back in the defensive end now. Tri-County moving up ice. There's Burdett. Intercepts puck. Gillis. And it's on fire, and that was Lincoln. He had Mooney beat, but it was too wide to the near side post. Dan Lincoln gets puck back. Cycles around to the top of the slot. Stick checked away by Burdett. Back the other way, that was Harrington. You can bet they're zeroing in on him.
Yeah, three players on him there, and he still almost made it in.
Quinn fires it, and it goes off the end glass, gets his own rebound, centering pass, looking towards Lincoln. Lincoln trying to jam it home, and Mooney there for the save. Tempers again flaring, and as soon as Quinn gets there, tempers cool.
Dangerous opportunity in close there for the freshman, Dan Lincoln. He's a very good offensive player, averaging well over a point a game. Had a beautiful what's called goal to put Sacred Heart up 1-0 against Dennis Yarmouth last week here. They turned the puck over in tight, and he's not the guy to make that kind of play against. And before you knew it, was up over the goalie's shoulder, top corner, and the Saints were out to a 1-0 lead, a lead they never relinquished.
Gillis out there to take the draw. Just inside a minute to go now. 4-3, the Tri-County lead. Sacred Heart would love to tie this game up for the second intermission. Collision at the half wall. Moving out with the puck are the Cougars. Trying to set up shop in the attacking end is D'Souza. Couldn't work it towards McCaffrey. 29 seconds to go. McCaffrey redirects the puck. D'Souza lost it. Here comes Kazmowski. Kazmowski got held a little bit. No call. Kazmowski up the right wing. Beam worked on by Capobianco. Kazmowski trying to get it back towards Quinn. He did. Knocked away. Back into the neutral zone by Firm. Would have been offside if Sacred Heart had touched the puck. Here's Firm with 6 seconds to go. Firm tees it up, and they're going to call an offside. That was a hard shot. One stick save made by Mooney anyways. 4 seconds to go. We're going to get a draw in the neutral zone that will pretty much do it for the period, barring a miracle rush. Sander, if you're a Sacred Heart, you can't be too happy with this second period.
Considering you came in with the lead and then you gave up 3 goals, and you know now you're looking going to the locker room down one in a critical league game, no, you can't be happy at all.
Draws a bit of a stalemate. That will do it for the second period. Puck goes up into the protective netting off the stick of Firm. So that will do it for the second period. Sacred Heart entered leading 2-1. They leave it trailing 4-3. I wouldn't go anywhere this intermission. We're going to have some interview guests from Sacred Heart. Guests still to be determined. Could be some former captains. Could be some current players. We'll see. But either way, Andrew and I will be here, and then we will be back for the third period action in about 10 minutes here at MyHockeyLive.com. Welcome back to the Bog. Third period action coming up here. Sacred Heart taking on Tri-County. The Saints trail this one 4-3 after two periods. I'm Jake Levin alongside Andrew Greenberg. Andrew, not a good period if you're a Saints fan.
To say the least.
Come into the period with a 2-1 lead. Yeah, leave with a 4-3 deficit. This team could score with the best of them. We'll see what happens over the final 15 minutes or so.
Well, at least they gave up some variety, an even strength goal, a power play goal, a penalty shot goal.
Teed up from the far side circle by Quinn and a save made by Mooney. Quinn again trying to force the puck in there. Dan Lincoln, far corner boards. Connor Harrington comes out with the puck. Harrington has scored 3 of the 4 goals tonight for Tri-County, including the first 3. He had 2 in the second period, one of them the penalty shot goal you alluded to.
Yeah, I think they might want to pay a little bit of attention to him this period.
Bad turnover there for the Saints, and a save made by Fillion. It hit the post, and then he covered it up with his glove. Very dangerous play. Chris Boyd was in trying to give the Cougars a 2-goal lead with 14 to play.
Well, I think Sacred Heart got to consider themselves quite fortunate there that for the second straight period they didn't give up a goal in the first minute of play. Not a good thing. Coaches will tell you, goals in the first minute of the period, last minute of the period are really what you look to avoid.
Those are the deadliest, especially when you're already trailing. Here's Ryan Leonard. He has his first goal of the season tonight, first goal of his career. He's also responsible for the penalty that resulted in the penalty shot for Connor Harrington.
Well, so you got some good, some bad, but for a young player, you know, not even a freshman yet, that's to be expected.
Exactly. Playing an outstanding game other than that mistake. Moving up is Leonard with the puck. Kind of working for Quinn. Coming up with it is Flanagan. Flanagan over for Most. Most too strong with it. Leonard comes up with the puck. Leonard long diagonal, trying to connect with him. Cafferty does so, but intercepted by Goss. Goss has it taken away by Quinn, who has it taken away by Harrington. Harrington gets tripped up, no call, may have fallen under his own power. Behind the net, it was Finn, moves to the half wall, can't connect on a long outlet with Dara Perry, who goes down in a collision right along the red line. C.J. Roy getting taken down with him. Here's Leonard, sends the puck into the attacking zone, gains the line, giving chase is Bassey McMillan. McMillan held up along the corner boards by Burdette, in towards a slot, and it went right onto the blades of Roy. He was able to knock it away. Still in the attacking zone, Finn off the half wall, looking towards, I believe that was McCafferty. Now towards Dara Perry, he's taking it up along the half wall. Harrington with the puck, able to get it over for Boyd. Chris Boyd retreats a bit in his defensive end with the puck, works it up for Ducharme. Ducharme, long pass for Harrington, could not connect, and that is going to be an icing. 12:14 to go in the third period.
And out comes Sacred Heart's second line. Lincoln Gillis and Walsh with the opportunity for a faceoff in the offensive zone. Let's see if they can win the draw here, maybe get an opportunity off the faceoff, some sort of set play. Oh, and it looks like
they're mixing it up a little bit.
Looks like they're mixing the lines up a bit here, putting out Quinn together with the two big freshmen, kind of aggregating things to have a big scoring line.
Quinn was in the aggressive position off that draw, too, atop the far side circle. Scrum along the half wall. Lincoln emerges, tried to get the shot off. It was blocked by Most. Still in the attacking zone, but finally out. Here come the Cougars. Had a chance for 2-on-1. They let the puck carry into the far corner. Skating with the puck is Cormac Perry. Worked it up towards Lincoln. He collides. Nasty collision atop the zone with Young. Both players are okay. Lincoln from the left wing, clean interception by Flanagan. Flanagan in, and he gets knocked away by Firm. An excellent defensive play there.
Yeah, Firm played that beautifully.
Cormac Perry, long diagonal up, couldn't connect with Lincoln cleanly. Goes right back towards McLaughlin. Top the attacking zone and dumped in for a line change by Walsh.
You know, should be interesting. Wow. Big hit there by number 18, Joshua McCafferty.
I think this is just going to be an offside and not a penalty. There's another big hit, as you said, Andrew. Play is getting physical, but it's of the clean variety.
Yeah, I'm interested to see if Coach McDonald is going to keep that big scoring line together. Lincoln Walsh with Quinn. Trailing a goal in the third period, probably not a bad move.
Gillis is out there now, flanked by Kazmuski and McCafferty. In the neutral zone, here's Kazmuski, going to go in, lone soldier by himself up the left wing. Kazmuski gets knocked off the play in the corner boards, taken away by Goss. Moving the puck out is McCaffrey, trying to anyways, goes up over the stick of D'Amelio. Back towards Lennon, almost intercepted. McCaffrey comes up with the puck, an impossible angle, and at the doorstep, knocked away by Sacred Heart. Goss at the point. Sends it off the sideboards. Leonard going to come up with the puck in his defensive end half wall. Couldn't handle it cleanly. Back towards D'Amelio. 10:15 to go, third period. Sacred Heart trails 4-3. Knocked off the play there was McCafferty by Boyd. Behind the net of Mooney. There's Dara Perry tangled up in the near side corner boards.
Yeah, physical play definitely picking up significantly here in the third period.
Doing battle with Ducharme. You've got Gillis down in there. A big cluster for the puck on the near side of the ice. Corner boards of the attacking end for Sacred Heart. Leonard emerges with the puck. Leonard wraps all the way around out in towards the slot. Saved by Mooney. Rebound coming out with the puck is McMillan. Top the slot, nobody home. Leonard keeps it alive. Redirected by Finn. It is Dara Perry firing it from the far side half wall. And couldn't get it on net and cleared out as though they were shorthanded by Tri-County. That's going to be costly. It's an icing. Sacred Heart will get a draw on their attacking end now with 9:23 to go.
You know, puck was right there in Sebastian McMillan's skates. He just didn't realize it. Very close to a significant scoring opportunity there. Good offensive pressure in that shift, though, for Sacred Heart. Definitely a positive. Maybe they can grab a little momentum from that.
That was their best shift of the period, easily. Going to be Dara Perry to take the draw. John Quinn flanked behind him in an aggressive spot.
Looks like Coach McDonald might be double shifting Quinn at this point.
You can't blame him, at least till they tie it up. As McMillan fires, score! McMillan not even sure that was intended to be a shot. It gets by Mooney, and Mooney knows it. He's still crouched down. He wants that back. That was a slow-moving puck, relatively speaking. Able to beat Mooney. It's a tied game, 4-4 with 9:11 to go in the third.
Yeah, Mooney was clearly surprised by that there. But, you know, good job by McMillan. Just get the puck on the net, see what happens. You know, as you see there, anything can happen. And they're changing goalies after that.
Very surprising. Joe Brown coming into the game.
Well, I guess Coach Spillane really was not impressed with that goal.
Soft goals happen. No reason to pull your goalie that's kept you in this game, though. A little surprised by that decision.
Yeah, not for only one misplay like that. I mean, if you'd given up a couple of bad goals, I'd be a lot more understanding, I think.
You know, if you go back to the Bruins game last night, Svedberg in the first period, yeah, deserved to be pulled. I don't know about that one.
I say that in one hand, but on the other hand, you know, Coach Blaine's got them in a 10-1 record. Obviously, he's been making good decisions, been pushing the right buttons, knows what he's doing. So I think you kind of got to give the coach with that kind of a record the benefit of the doubt.
We still have just under 9 minutes to figure out if it was the right decision or not. Dan Lincoln darting towards the puck, gets foot race between him and Ducharme, and colliding along the end boards. Lincoln went down. Capobianco down with him. Lincoln with the puck, moves it out to the point for Leonard at the near side. Leonard moving the puck further down for Walsh. Walsh tied up with Capobianco towards Lincoln. Shot, score! Dan Lincoln from Liam Walsh. And the early going, Andrew, it looks like maybe not the best decision by the Tri-County coach pulling Mooney.
Well, considering the first shot that the replacement goalie sees on net ends up on the back of the net. But the other side of things is you can't really blame the goalie for that play there. You know, Lincoln's set up on the far post there. The puck comes across. Really not much of a chance for the goaltender to come across on that. And as we stated before, Lincoln is a really talented offensive player. You give him an opportunity like that, he's not going to make a mistake with it too often at all.
Excellent feed from Walsh to set up Lincoln there. On the post, Sacred Heart back on top of this back and forth hockey game. They're on top 5-4 now.
We got a whole different game.
Here comes
all over
County.
Again.
Boyd with a shot and a glove save by Philly, and he robbed him.
Well, it looks like we're going to be in for a barn burner of an ending here.
This is what it's all about. Late in the season, February vacation on the horizon. The playoff chases are heating up.
You know, important critical league game between two of the top teams in the league. What else can you ask for?
Quinn opposing Harrington on the draw in a battle of titans. Harrington behind the net, looking for Goss. Goss overskated the puck. He had nobody covering him other than Fillion. Would have been shooter versus the goalie there to try to tie the game. Sacred Heart trying desperately to clear it out of the zone. It's Firm up the left side of the ice. Firm can go coast to coast as a defenseman. He does wear number 4. Firm sends it towards the near post, and covering that one up was Brown. Goes into the corner. Goss with the puck, moves out to the half wall. Firm in the neutral zone, sends it right near the Tri-County bench. The defensive pair is off for Sacred Heart and back on. Play the puck. Looks like Cormac Perry. Up towards Quinn, went between his legs. Darting in, that's Kazmowski. Kazmowski in the corner, swallowed up by two Tri-County players. Kazmowski trying to work the puck over towards McCafferty, who goes down. Now it's Quinn. Quinn, the wraparound bid, saved by Brown. It gets redirected along the end boards now. Quinn, lot of activity behind the net, skating out with the puck are the Cougars. It's McLaughlin. Working up towards Most. Most gains the line. 2-on-2. Most jams on the brakes in the slot, knocked away by Leonard. Cormac Perry behind the net. Cross ice for Dara Perry. Still alive in the Tri-County end. Perry went down to his legs, tried to knock it free from Roy. Able to do so. Here they come, 2-on-1. It's Quinn. Quinn into the far circle, trying to connect out ice with McMillan. Couldn't get it to him cleanly. Carries into the near corner boards. 6:21 to go. Sacred Heart on top, 5-4. Tied up on the near side half wall. Goss up there trying to work Darren Perry away from the puck. We also got Flanagan down in there. Flanagan emerged with the puck temporarily. Leonard takes him down. No call. Everybody wanted one. Not going to get it. This puck is carried all the way down icing. It's going to be an icing. Took a bit of a curve there beyond Fillion. Just what Sacred Heart wanted.
Absolutely. 5:56 left in the game. Clinging now to a one-goal lead. And now Tri-County's going to need somebody to step forward, come up with the equalizer, get them back in control. You got to wonder, perhaps Connor Harrington might have another one in him.
Well, Harrington, you know, Tri-County, they're already only rolling three lines. And, yeah, you can think Harrington, if you're already rolling three lines, you know, why not double shift them? Intercepted atop the attacking zone by Dara Perry. Checks it in backhand towards the corner. Stays with it, and it's Firm pinching him from the point to play the puck at the half wall, trying to find Perry. There's Harrington with a puck, moving towards the center of the ice, being worked on by Firm. It'll get the pass up for Boyd, and a penalty is going to be called against the Saints.
Actually, Jake, I think that was just an offside.
That's an offside. You are correct, Andrew.
Not to correct you.
No, that's big difference. Big difference there if you're Sacred Heart. Stays 5-on-5 hockey.
Big difference if you try county.
Absolutely. Tobby attacking zone. Ducharme keeps it alive. Dan Lincoln with a puck. Lincoln skating backwards and able to clear the zone. Finally does so up for Quinn now. 3-on-2. John Quinn. Defender tripped up. It was CJ Roy firing it on net. And saved by Brown. Quinn had the game on his stick right there. Would have been 6-4 with about 5 minutes to go.
I'll tell you, that was a heck of a save by Brown there to keep Tri-County in this game. Falling behind by two at this point would be nothing but bad.
Dan Lincoln's shot was deflected off the stick of Roy inside 5 minutes ago. Now here's Quinn moving in the left circle. Quinn tried to go between the legs of Roy. Roy able to thwart that plan. Sends it into the neutral zone, picked up by Finn. Finn able to work it up for Lincoln, who gains the line. Quinn picks up the puck. Quinn going to go behind the net. The backhand wraparound bid. Rebound out in front. Nobody home in the slot. Lincoln fanned at the puck. Kept alive by Leonard out at the point. For Quinn. Down for Leonard on the near point. Firing it. And Lincoln trying to redirect it in the slot. Quinn fires on it. Saved by Brown. Rebound. It goes wide to the far side of the post. Nobody was home for Sacred Heart. 4:16 to go. They're cycling around the attacking zone. That was Walsh trying to work the puck. Over towards Quinn, near half wall. Quinn moves off for Lincoln. Went a little too cute there. Coming up is Boyd. We're inside 4 minutes to go now. Quinn tees it up, and it goes over the head of Brown off the end glass. Keeping alive at the point is Finn. Down low for Lincoln. Calling for the puck in the middle is Walsh. And trying to kick it out of Tri-County. They're able to do so. Harrington weakly knocks at the puck. It's Leonard. Here comes Walsh now. Walsh in through the near circle. Leaving it. For Leonard's shot, and it goes wide to the far side of the post. You having fun, Andrew. This is unbelievable. Here comes Tri-County back the other way.
I'll tell you, it's a great way to protect a lead to keep the puck 180 feet from your own net.
Bringing up the near left side is Gillis. Has it knocked away by Goss. Pops up over everyone. 3:20 to go. Gillis in the slot, a save by Brown. It went wide. Kazmuski back over to McCafferty. McCafferty in the near corner. Sends puck looking towards Gillis. He gets tangled up along the end boards with McLaughlin. Goss and Kazmuski battle in the far corner now. It's Gillis who wound up with puck and fired it well wide. Went into the corner. Now at the near half wall. We're inside 3 minutes ago. Picking out. We're going to get a penalty called against Tri-County. I think it's Dan McLaughlin that's going to go.
You know, Tri-County almost looks these last couple of shifts like they're just out of gas. I'd also like to add, though, Brown with four excellent saves over those last two shifts. Maybe Coach Blaine did know a little something.
Hard to second guess after all.
Because this game could be over if it wasn't for him.
And these are going to be offsetting penalties here, Andrew. Not only is McLaughlin going to go, it looks like Gillis is in the box as well for Sacred Heart. And yet, it stays 5-on-5 hockey. Didn't see anything too out of the ordinary in terms of extracurriculars.
No, I think the Tri-County player, you know, he did stay on top of him when he was down the ice probably a second or two longer than was strictly necessary.
2:54 to go in the game. Sacred Heart on top, 5-4 here at the Bog. Wednesday night hockey on MyHockeyLive.com. in the attacking end. Another collision. Dan Lincoln went down, no call.
Yeah, Lincoln on the receiving end of a pretty darn hard hit there.
There's another collision behind the play. Quinn was getting tangled up with Nick Young. And a little punch thrown there. So join, that was Roy. Fillion makes a save out to the corner boards. Game is getting very physical in a one-goal game, 2 minutes and change to go. Along the end boards, Cormac Perry works the puck up ice for Walsh. Walsh goes it alone by himself up the right wing, and he's going to take a full line change.
You know, I understand wanting to fight fire with fire, but I'm sure Coach McDonald would prefer his team maybe dial it back a little bit here. The last thing in the world you want to do is take a penalty with a one-goal lead right at the end.
1 minute, 50 seconds to go. Off ice is Young. Gained the line, knocked away by Firm. From beyond the blue line, fired by Roy, and that goes off the end boards. Dan Lincoln in the far corner defensively around the perimeter. Out at the near point, Goss couldn't stop it. Moving up was Dara Perry, redirected in through the neutral zone. Now it's Flanagan up the right side of the ice. Flanagan fires well wide off the end boards. Brown is out of the net. It is 6-on-5 hockey. And now here comes Gillis. Gillis up the far left side. Knocked away. That's going to be an offside. Minute 16 to go, and this is going to bring Brown right back out. Draw is going to be in the neutral zone.
Yeah, and you got to figure as soon as Tri-County crosses the red line again, Brown's going to come right back out for the sixth skater.
Tri-County wins the draw, but it goes deep into their own end. Minute 12 to go. Bezgian couldn't get any rush going. Leonard redirects it behind the net. Sagan Hart in pure prevent defense mode right now. Quinn with the puck through the left circle. Quinn with some moves. Quinn can't get the shot off, but moves it further down ice towards Walsh, who gets trapped up in the corner, and this is just fine if you're Sagan Hart. Tri-County can't afford to bleed any more clock here. 43 seconds to go. Quinn emerges with a puck. Quinn in through the doorstep, backhand, and it goes wide to the far side off the end boards. Foul zone rebound, has to play around the ref. And it has cleared the length of the ice. It will not be an icing. Got tangled up in the corner. Leonard's going to be the first one down there for Sacred Heart. Knocked off the play by Flanagan. 22 seconds to go. The net is empty on the other end. Top of the attacking end, Leonard. Able to play the puck away from Ducharme. Leonard trying to clear, almost sent it right towards Harrington. With 12 seconds left, darting at it was Lincoln. He couldn't get there, had a wide open net in front of him. 8 seconds to go, Harrington overskates the puck. Quinn able to redirect it. Quinn gently tries to clear, 2 seconds to go. At the half wall, Leonard sends it back the other way. And Sacred Heart will escape with a 5-4 victory over Tri-County.
You know, that is a big win for the Saints of Sacred Heart. They go out at 8-5-2 overall in the year, but most importantly, 6-1-2 in the Mayflower League. Tri-County goes to 10-2 in the year, 6-2 in the Mayflower League. Huge, what's called league win against two of the top teams there for Sacred Heart. And you got to give them a lot of credit. They had a bad second period. They came out that third period. You know, they had those two quick goals, you know, probably a minute or two apart to take the lead. The second half of that period, you know, Sacred Heart really carried the play. Protecting that lead aggressively. They had them pinned down in their own defensive zone for, you know, large periods of time, and they really finished that game strong.
Absolutely. You know, they played a pretty good first period. They did give up the first goal of the game to Connor Harrington. That wouldn't be the last we heard from him. Able to get two back, go into the locker room with that one-goal lead. 12 seconds into the second period, it's Harrington again, and then Harrington later on in the period with a penalty shot. And then again, that time it wasn't Harrington. I guess that would have been Dan McLaughlin. 4-3 lead for Tri-County heading into the third, and Sacred Heart responds about as well as one can respond with adversity. They come out of here with 2 points.
Yeah, I mean, they showed a lot of character there. They really did. You know, when you get knocked down, you know, you just got to get back up, get right back on the horse, and, you know, like we said, after a really disappointing second period, they came out with a very impressive third period. And they got the 2 points, and, you know, that's your goal at the end of the game.
That's what good teams need to do. So Tri-County, they will fall to 6-2 in the Mayflower Conference, 10-2 overall. All right, so thank you, everyone, for tuning in tonight on MyHockeyLive.com. Thank you to Art, man in the camera. for Andrew Greenberg. I'm Jake Levin. We will be back. I know we got a full slate of action on Saturday in Falmouth and Rhode Island and everywhere else in between. There is plenty more hockey left on MyHockeyLive.com this season.
Yep, for anybody who's up for it on Saturday, you can watch hockey on MyHockeyLive all afternoon and all evening long.
Yes, you can. All right, for Andrew Greenberg, I'm Jake Levin. See you next time. MyHockeyLive.com.
Hey-o.